Besoma Kerala, Besoma Commander, Bonjour. Comrades, si à Alan le programme est tout. Kamalam ngu Vusumuzwa Makhoza ngusihlalo we province ya KwaZulu Natal ku EFF sizocela i leadership ye province ekhona la igibele ize last stage oyihlalo nonobhala ba ma region abakhona bakhuphuke beze last stage ne RCT yasemajuba uma ikhona ikhuphuke ize last stage ukuze siba introduce ngendlela efanele sihlalo waza wesihlalo kwamajubu sondele ngala siyazi ukuthi leadership ibhizi ke lapha phansi kodwa ke ayisondele ngifuna ukuthatha leli thuba introduce i-leadership ye-province ekhona lana. I'm going to start with I see unobhala wase Sisonke region angithi into yasemajuba le kodwa ke khona amanye ama-region azivakashele. So I'm going to start by introducing them. Unobhala wase Herigwala sondela ubabingelele
amandla amandla viva EFF viva
viva
EFF viva igama lami ndingunomfundo ngokwampayipheli from Herigwala ngiyabonga.
Ngibona unobhala usihlalo waseThekwini metro ukhona
amandla 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 phansi ngabadayisi phansi phansi ngabadayisi phansi down with corruption down amandla usihlalo waseThekwini umlebuka kahlengwe ngiyambikelela
ngibona usihlalo wasemkhanyakude le enyakatho bathi abawuphatha umuthi bagile imama
mandla mandla
awethu
down corruption down
down
corruption down
ngibona unobhala wasothukela akasonde
amandla amandla igama usifiso kwamadondo unobhala wasothukela
ubona usihlalo weregion wasothukela
amandla
amandla
viva EFF viva
viva
EFF
viva
phansi ngamasela phansi phansi ngamasela phansi
usihlalo wasothukela lo ukhumbulani langa
ngicela ukusondele unobhala unobhala wase Maju amandla awe tu kula mathuba kula down with entita
unobhala ubusihlalo wase Maju usihlalo wase Maju ngibiza manje usihlalo wasemajuba uzofika a-introduce asiyamazi ukuthi isilomo kahleni uzofika introduce i-RCT yakhe ubuholi bakhe be-region maqedane bese yasemukela angithi le mash eyala emajuba eyala e-Newcastle sub-region so ke uzofika a-introduce ubuholi bakhe bese yasemukela ngokusemthethweni singavele siqaqamuke nje singamukelwanga thatha
mandla awethu qina majuba region qina phansi thunda amahlaba phansi ran thunda amahlaba ran ran thunda amahlaba ran ran ANC ran mandla awethu
amandla
siyabonga kakhulu fighters ngaphandle kokuchitha isikhathi let me introduce the regional command team of amajuba the most hard working regional command team of majuba so ngizoqala nje comrades with the head of mobilization the organizer of the region a ground force fighter Vusumuzi Shabalala
Mandla. Mandla. Niyaba sabana. Niyaba sabana.
Bese silandela ngo fighter unkutha osedela i portfolio yakwa health in the region amandla
amandla awethu
bese kuba u fighter umthunzi osedela i security in the region amandla
amandla amandla ayeye tunda ayeye wethunda sesifikile tunda sifikile
amandla bese si introducer osedela i social development in the region u fighter Nomalanga Shabalala Mandla bese si introducer osedela i finance department imali zethu emajuba u fighter Thembi kupheka Mandla
Amandla Amandla forward imbokodo forward
forward
imbokodo forward
forward lapho
Mandla.
Hey
two.
Mandla.
Fighters, engikuzele kuzoba kuncane kakhulu. I am here to welcome all of you and then also to thank all of you. Ground forces ebesinawo from umhla siqala up until today. I thank you community of Newcastle, ground forces of Emadlangeni, ground forces of Dannhauser, all of you fighters. We thank you for your dedication. We thank you for never abandoning the struggle. This is only the beginning of what is big to come. Are we clear? Also, fighters, let me also thank the chairs and the secretaries of branches. Let me thank the branch command teams and everyone who is here. Ngaphandle kokuchithisikhathi, ngiyanamukela nonke fighters. Ngamukela ozakwethu. Who lead in regions across KwaZulu Natal, Osihlalo Nobhala, the deputy chairs of regions. Sinamukela nonke fighters, samukela wonke umuntu okhona. We are here to shake the status quo. Indoda esatshwa iNewcastle yonke, we are here to tell him that he is nothing and he is going to go back where he comes from because we are reclaiming Newcastle. Newcastle is ours. Mandla! Hey, two! Mandla! Hey, two!
Mandla! Hey, uqinisile sihlalo makuthiwa isiqhaga uyasoxonga isiqhaga ngakubo hayi la. Sikhona thina manje. Ngizothatha leli thuba we are moving very fast. Ngoba sifuna ukunika lamasela le memorandum. Bese siwanqumela ugwayi katiki. Ngizokhumbula ke fighters ukuthi kuke kwaba nesimo se lockdown. Kwase kudingeka ukuthi abasebenzi bahlale emakhaya kube nezinto ezithize ezimali ekufanele bayithole. Ngokuqala lokho abanye kwafanele ukuthi bathole imali ye UIF lamasela abaqashi abevesane ayithathe ayihlephule bese nikeza abantu shintshi. Amanye amasela abaqashi abengabaniki inhlobo abantu bakithi. Mabethi baya complain abaxoshwe. La nje kulo masipala siyakubona kuxoshwe abasebenzi abangaphezulu kwethuku kwamakhulu amabili abebesebenza la kwangalandelwa ama procedures ngoba bacabanga ukuthi bayiqhwaka bacabanga ukuthi ba untouchable kudlalwa ngabantu abamnyama ukudlala ngomuntu omnyama kwagcina mhla kwazalwa iEFF it will never happen whether you are a racist whether you are an employer noma uyibhokholo lika khongolose uthi wena wawuyibambile ehlathini langakini bese uthi uphuma ehlathini futhi yabona ma ungabo bahlonipha labantu ababethi bona baku exile amagwala izinto ezabaleke elimpi
sasala sayibamba sadutshulwa amaZP sashaywa inkatha sashaya amaphunu behleli kuexile bedlugologo bizayo odoti bese bebuya bathi balwela lelizwe babehleli kuexile behleli kumnandi hawu soze sadlala lo doti lapho. So the comrades came, EFF then established the labor desk ezolekelela abasebenzi uma ubebhekene neyinkinga. Siyazi abasebenzi bayaxhashazwa, ukhongolose uhlangana nabaqashi kuxhashazwe abasebenzi bathengwe. Uthi uya kwa Department of Labor uthole kuqashwa abantu ba-ANC bakudayise kumqashi. Uthi uya kwi-CCMA kuqashwe abantu baka-ANC bathathe i-bribe kumqashi. Black person, you are on your own. Ukhongolose nenkatha ne-DA abanandaba nawe. All they care about ukuba ama-security guard a white monopoly capital. Esikushoyoke bafowethu, EFF established the labor desk ukuze ilekelele abasebenzi kuyo yonke imkhakha. Kwase kujutshwa ukomisa Hlengiwe Mkhaliphi ukuthi akube uyena oba usihlalo waleli desk elibhekelele indaba zabasebenzi. Ukhona la namhlanje, ngifuna ukumethula athi qaphuqaphu ukuthi i-labor desk isebenza kanjani, isuka ku-national iye provinsini, nanokuthi abantu abathintwayo iziphi izinto okufanele kudilwe ngazo. Sayinikeza imbokodo bathi vesani fike lapha egeyithini athi uyaphuma ubasi John, do you want to John vula igate?
Abandla inamsebenzi qina, inamsebenzi qina, sekudala bokudala sisebenzi lama kwebasebenzi
amasebenzi amasha
awu sekudala bo sisebenzi lama kwebasebenzi
amasebenzi amasha.
Abasebenzi nasihlalo NSG. Inamsebenzi qina. Sekudala bokudala sisebenze lamaphunu ebasebenze. Sekudala bokudala
sisebenze lamaphunu
ebasebenze. Africa, izwe lethu, awu yezwe lokhokho, awu ayamabhono, awu emzansi Africa. Ngiyabonga kakhulu sihlalo weprovinsi ne PCT members and RCT leadership of Amajuba and SG, our people's SG. Yes, Ustalo have introduced me as Komisa Shengwe Mkhalipi, who is the lead of Labour Desk. Ustalo ke anginqoqele ukuthi yini i-Labour Desk. I-Labour Desk i-desk leli elisiza abasebenzi abaxhashazwayo every day. So uma ke nonke la niphuma emabranchini, ground forces, nihlangabezana ney'nkinga every day, besitshela omama, besitshela obaba bethu ukuthi la ngisebenza khona, ngiyabizwa ngekafula, ngikhokhelwa imali encane, angihlonishwa, anginayo ngisho i-dignity. So bayashawa abasebenzi nabasebenza khona. So ke i-Labour Desk ye-EFF ibuyisa isithunzi somuntu omnyama. So ke kufanele ukuthi sonke mangabe sinama issues a-raise abasebenzi ngokuhlukahlukene, siqala kwi-tiers, le mali le yakhishwa uhulumeni ngesikhathi siya kwi-lockdown. Wenza iphutha ke ngoba lo uhulumeni esimashelayo namhlanje la uhulumeni wamaphutha. Yingakho nje ngomhlaka ngo-2021 kufanele simkhiphe lo uhulumeni sifake uhulumeni we-EFF. Ngoba all the time uhulumeni wamaphutha. Uthe qala nje ethi akafuni kube khona umsebenzi ozothi mehlele ekhaya ngenxa ye-lockdown bese engabi nento azoyidla nokuthi nefamily yakhe ingalali ingadlili. Iphutha ke lokuqala ke base befaka ke le mali ye-UIF bayifaka kubaqashi.
Yebo.
Abaqashi ke banifihlela ngoba becabanga ukuthi ayikho i-EFF ezokwazi ukuthi iyolwela. So ke silwa lolo dabi ke lokuthi uma ngabe imali yakho uyakwazi nokuyi-checka kwi-app yaka-Labour Department. Uma nje uke wayithola ukuthi imali yakho yakhishwa ngomhlazane thizeni, kodwa umqashi wakho akakunikanga imali yakho e-TERS, uqonda e-ofisini le-EFF. Ufike uyoreporta kulona, ukhona-ke umuntu oqondene ne-Labour Desk ema-ofisini. La imajuba nje u-deputy chair we-region okuyena oyi-head of Labour Desk. Kwi-province u-deputy chairperson uMongezithwala okuyena oqondene ne-Labour Desk at a provincial level. Akufuneke ihambeke izifike nakuma sub-regions ngoba abantu ngeke bakwazi ukuthi bonke beze ofisini ngesikhathi esisodwa. So ama-regions nama-branches uma ngabe enza ama-programs awo kufuneke benze sure ukuthi indaba yabasebenzi yokurojwa kwabo iy'nkampani ey'barobhayo iya-addresswa leyo nto nayiletha kuthina nayiletha kwi-Labour Desk. Ngakho-ke sinama-programs akhona. Uma ngikhuluma nje la ngomhlaka 8 sobe simashela i-bargaining council lapha eThekwini ngoba uma niqashiwe kukhona nabanirobhayo abathi nijoyine i-union iningayazi nane-union. Nibanjelwe imali ey'nkulu kuthiwa uyimemba ye-union, muthi uyabheka ukuthi angikaze ngijoyine i-union nje. Bese kuthiwa cha, i-decision ye-bargaining council eyathathwa on your behalf. So ke ubuholi be-province ubutheke ngomhlaka 8 ake sihambeke so-confront ama-bargaining council kanye ne-CCMA kanye ne-Department of Labour ukuthi akekho umuntu okufuneke ajoyine i-union ngaphandle kokuthi kube uyena o-authorizer indaba ye-union. Okwesibili-ke ama-union are very useless e-South Africa. Sinale nkinga nje yokuthi abaqashi basigibele emakhanda ngoba asinawo ama-union. Ama-union ayathengwa. Ufika lapha uthi une-shop steward, uthi ujoyine i-union ukhiphe imali every month, thola i-shop steward ukuthi ayisakubheki sihlafunini. So ke thina njenge-Labour Desk uma wasitshela nje inkinga yakho singena ney'caba kumqashi sifike simbuze ukuthi iphi imali yalo msebenzi osebenza kanzima awuyikhokhi ngani. Okumnandi-ke sihlalo lano SG ne-leadership ukuthi i-Labour Desk ayicharge ngisho i-cent. So kufuneke laba bantu abathi bayanicharge ngoba ngibonile ukuthi khona nonomgogwana la abathi balolo basebenza emafemini. I can tell you now ukuthi labo nomgogwana bacharge abantu bakithi abayihluphekele abagqilazwa nabaqashi babo. Thina-ke njenge-Labour Desk asikucharge ngisho i-cent ngoba ziyinhlangano ethanda abasebenzi, ethanda abantu abahluphekayo. So ke hambani-ke ma-branches, hambani-ke nonke ma-ground forces, if kunezinkinga zabasebenzi ey'riphothwa kunina, niyilethe e-ofisini le-EFF, i-Labour Desk izokwazi ukuthi iyixazulule. Amandla sihlalo, amandla!
EFF emajuba region ayikhule,
ayikhule.
EFF emajuba region ayikhule,
ayikhule.
Phansi ngamasela kakhongolose phansi, phansi ngamasela kathambo phansi, mandla. Angibonge sihlalo, ngibingele leadership ma ground forces, leadership ye region, leadership ye province, okomisa from national balitho nobuqhophololo obenziwa kulo masipala. So lokho kwenzeka la kumasipala akukhona ngempela okufuze ngabe kuyenzeka akukhona laba bantu abakhethelwa khona lokho abakhethelwa khona bakhethe ukuthi abalethe iservice delivery kubantu kodwa bayenze service abayilethe iservice delivery kubantu kunalokho bayifaka emakhikini abo so yilokho esisho esizolwa nakho ke namhlanje ngokungachitha isikhathi sine leadership e province PCT members ngizocela ukuthi angobone manje abanye baphansi lapho bengajabula njena awu bengajabula njena uTK uphamsisana ngicela PCT members ngizocela ukuqala Gugu Gugu Mtshali PCT member
Amandla Amandla Viva EFF Viva Viva amajuba viva phansi ngamasela ka ANC phansi phansi ngamasela ka ANC phansi ugugu wakwaMtshali from eZululand ngiyabonga
mama Dlamini sicela uze ngaphambili uNomvu yelelo Dlamini PCT member Amandla 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 Viva EFF 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 Viva Panti ngo ANC Panti Panti ngamasela ka ANC Panti Amandla
Wethu Besandaz sine kodwa uprovincial secretary wethu mina kunombiyelelo wakaDlamini Harry Gwala sisonke inkosi
Fatima sicela ngaphambili Fatima Fatima PCT member Fatima Khanyile sicela ngaphambili uyikhansela futhi eThekwini
Amandla
Hey Grand Force kele. Mtutu Mtutu Mthetho, sicela uze ngaphambili PCT member.
Manda! Forward with the land expropriation without compensation forward. Forward with the free decolonized education forward. Manda!
Umthetho wezimthetho bese ngishilo sicela uTK wazwa nje ngoTK eze ngaphambili PCT member Amandla Amandla awethu awethu uthokozani langa from eThekwini region sicela uLinda Mbele uTreasurer weProvince uSozimali
Amandla Amandla Viva EFF, viva!
Viva!
Down corruption, down!
Down!
Down ANC, down! Kula EFF, machuba, kula! Manda!
Deputy Secretary at the provincial level, Upeli Herix, steleze ngaphambili.
Viva EFF, viva!
Viva!
Qina machuba, qina!
Viva!
Phansi ngamagcinezeli, phansi! Forward, EFF, forward!
Forward!
Upelwa ka Herix, usekela nobhala from eMgungundlovu region, ngiyabonga.
Sengizothula elingamaziyo la, uDeputy Chair at the provincial level, uMongezi Thwala, Deputy Chair.
Manza! Manza! Long live the Commander-in-Chief Julius Salom Malema, long live! Long live the Commander-in-Chief Julius Salom Malema, long live! Ayikhule EFF, ayikhule! Ayikhule EFF, ayikhule! Down with ANC emalahleni reaching down! Down with ANC emalahleni reaching down! Mandla! Run ANC, run! Run ANC, run! Mandla!
Sengizothula ke manje usihlalo weprovinsi uVusi Muzi Khoza, Mandla!
Hamba nobhala hamba!
Mandla! Viva EFF viva! Phansi namasela kaKhongolose phansi! Niyabasabana!
Sibasabi,
siyabafuna! Niyabasabana!
Sibasabi,
kaju. Asim sab, siyamufu. Sizo kubera nohlelo lwethu, sizela ukuzokwethula uhlu lwekhalazo. Uhlu lwekhalazo, esizolwethula la, sizolufunda. Sesikhona ke isikhulu esivela laphayana emnyangweni lo esiubiza ngokhokta. Okuyilo mnyango obhekelele ezokubusa ngokwendabuko uphinde futhi ubhekelele ukusebenza kwamasipala onokubusa ngokubambisana. Iwona lo mnyango ofike uthi makufanele kuyobekwa inkosi uvele ubeke umngani nobhululu wabo. Inkosi yona yona ingagcotshwa. Iwona lo mnyango okuthiwa makuthiwa kufanele kuholelwe induna. Balale ngakusasa sebenezabo induna nje libanjwe balikhiphe futhi laba olifake engcenye liqhubeke litshotshe lamasela la kwayishela umama uSibokhawula. Kodwa kukhona omela umnyango angimazi ngoba mangimthula kuzobe ngazi ukuthi ubhulu lwami angimazi uzoyisho lo yena. So ke ukukomisa uNontando uNoluntshungu uNontando okuwukomisa okhonvina ama CCT deployees la KwaZulu Natal okhona nathi la uzoyifunda imemorandum ayihandover kudokotela okhona la ozoyilanda athi mase ihandovile isayinwe bese eyazethula ngoba kungathi wasayinika nje omunye umbhemu wangena la emva kwetruck washawa chithi thi ubani igama la kuthi wasilizwanga sibo zethula mayeze qeda ukuzethula bese yasho ukuthi uyisaphi le memorandum. Komisa Nontando ungasondela usifundele lo fighters sibona le movement ama fighter loke yale asisondeleni amandla high moral thank you marshals attend to those fighters abenzi up and down we are serious here thank you
chair mangibulise inkokheli zethu ezikhoyo apha namuhla ngibulise nabahlali ndithi amandla amandla viva CIC viva long live the CIC long live qina mhlali qina qina mhlali qina amandla bahlali sila namhlanje sizokudlulisa uluhlu lwezikhalazo zethu angithi sina more than 26 years sivotela ANC maruma hluka siuboni instead sibona kuye kuba ngaphezulu kwangoku sasinga ba before baphathe sizowuthi namhlanje kwanele ku ANC sininikile voti zethu amanyaka ay 26 bara siboni any difference
yeah
nazi ke izikhalazo esithe sasidwelisa namuhla esizothi sizidelivarishe kumasipala. The Newcastle municipality has been flagged by the provincial coctor in its presentation to the national coctor portfolio notice as one of the dysfunctional municipalities in the province of KwaZulu-Natal. Below are the listed concerns that we are raising. One, that the municipality is owing Eskom more than 200 million rands, uThukela water 100 million, and therefore running a risk of a collapse of these basic services, which are essential to our communities. Two, that the municipality has dismissed more than 200 employees, resulting in a lack of service delivery in our communities, and also that municipality has appointed service providers at exorbitant amounts to replace the dismissed employees. Three, that the EPW workers have in some instances been appointed to replace the dismissed employees and paid overtime, which is not permitted in terms of the conditions of the EPWP mandate. Four, that the municipality has failed to provide a clean and healthy environment as required by the Constitution of the Republic. Five, that the municipality has insisted in appointing the head of department for planning and human settlements, despite despite objections by the MEC for Kogta through a letter as well as per Kogta's assessment report produced in June 2019. Five, that the municipality is alleged to have made irregular appointments of 12 traffic wardens and 23 cleaners, thereby denying our youth the opportunity to be appointed in a fair and transparent manner as per the constitution of the country. Seven, that the municipality has not been transparent on the process of procurement of PPEs, where our councillors have been sent from pillar to post when posing these questions in council. Eight, that the executive committee has allegedly been paying itself allowances that were not approved by the MEC in terms of Section 12 notice. Eight, that there are appointments being made without the correct vetting process taking place and resulting in wrong appointments being made. That some of the staff members, including the acting municipal manager, are alleged to have been implicated in the forensic reports commissioned by the municipality, Kogta, and Treasury. The municipality is said to be appointing advocates for simple internal cases at exorbitant rates and without complying with Section 217 of the Constitution of the Republic. That the deputy mayor is alleged to have been involved in an accident using a municipal car and is currently undergoing a criminal case, but without municipality taking any action against him in terms of the code of conduct for councillors for abusing a council asset. That the municipality has engaged in a court matter and defending a political party matter when the party has decided not to defend the dismissal of its own member. That the irregular advertisement of the post of the municipal manager, irregular procurement and payment of 2.8 million rands for PPEs, irregular procurement of the service providers for the construction of roads in the tune of 54 million rands, the alleged irregular appointment of a director of human resource without qualifications, failure to manage overtime paid to staff has been raised by the EFF in council with no accountability whatsoever, and where council is seen to be harboring the wrongdoing of the administration be rectified immediately and the necessary criminal action be brought against anybody involved in these activities. That the failure to manage the municipality and the acts of corruption and maladministration has robbed the residents of Newcastle, Madadeni, Osizweni, and all the surrounding areas of decent and quality services, as the money aimed for service delivery gets channeled for other use other than service delivery. That this has resulted in a poor or no water supply in areas like Ward 6, Ward 13, Ward 15, Ward 16, and parts of Ward 18. Poor collection of refuse, particularly in Madadeni, Osizweni, and neighboring areas. Potholes and the neglect of the maintenance of roads in the above areas, as well as unfinished housing projects, that is in Ward 30. We therefore assert the following, that the Council of Newcastle has failed to exercise oversight in its administration, resulting in poor service delivery, financial mismanagement, acts of nepotism, maladministration, and corruption. That as a result of the failure to exercise such oversight, the municipality as a public institution has degenerated itself into a battleground of the functional battles of the ANC and longer owned by the citizens and no longer owned by the citizens of this town. We therefore demand that the province immediately invoke section 139, subsection 1B of the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa in order to restore order, confidence, and quality services to our people in Newcastle. That the lights other than errant municipalities, the MEC for Kochta, with immediate effect, commission a section 106 investigation into the municipality and appoint an administrator to ensure that service delivery is reinstated in the municipality. That immediate suspension and disciplinary action of the deputy mayor for causing harm to the assets of the public without any consequences, as well as the speaker for failing to act in accordance with the code of conduct for councillors against the deputy mayor. The immediate suspension of the acting municipal manager to allow for the undetailed investigation into allegations of corruption, nepotism, and maladministration in his administration. We therefore demand that the above matter be seen as serious and as impacting very negatively on the lives of the people of Newcastle. That immediate and urgent investigations are carried out, resulting in a successful criminal prosecution of all persons involved in the gross acts of abuse and victimization of the people of Newcastle. Finally, we therefore demand an emailed response to this memorandum in 30 days from the date of delivery, that is today, to the following emails. I am now going to hand over the memorandum to the representative of the municipality.
Why sign now? Why sign
now? Why
sign now? Why tata? Why tata? Sign now! 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 Agasake to sign a $1 million signature. Signature, I'm a celebrity. Ukuba usayine lo 5 million njalo ngabe dale uqedwe. Wayithatha, wayithatha. Wayisayina, wayisayina. Sizomnikeza ke official ethu izethule maqedane isho ukuthi izoyenzani ile memorandum ngoba uthunyiwe.
Stalo the province the leadership EFF ekhona ubuholi the EFF Majuba sicela ukubingelela nomphakathi wonke nama membership yonke EFF ekhona la
yabo
ngikumpumelelo kwaZulu eminyangweni okwa Khokta ngithukile unqonqoshe ukuba ngizwayemukela ngaphansi kwegama lakhe le memorandum edila ney'nkinga ey'khona la umasipala wase-Newcastle. Sicabanga ukuthi within 7 days sizobuyisa impendulo ye-acknowledgement bese-ke sihlela ne-feedback meetings esicabanga ukuthi ubuholi be-Labour Desk EFF buzowamukela imihlangano esizoyicela nabo ukuze sikwazi ukuresponda kwezinye izinto ey'thinta uKhokta kakhulu bese lezi ey'thinta umasipala ngicabanga ukuthi kuzoba nama-processes akhona ezobe sicela umasipala asiphe iy'mpendulo zakhona. Ngiyabonga kakhulu.
Sibonga baba, thank you very much. Siyabonga. Angithi akhona ama-officiali enza umsebenzi wayo aziyo ukuthi asebenzela abantu bese kuba khona lawa eyisayo. So siyabonga ukuthi i-official lethu njengoba belithunyiwe lize la lenze lokhu ebelikusele. Sesizoqhubeka ke manje sibize isikhulumi sethu sosuku ekuzosethula. Ubujuju. Boza la. Juju, boza. Ubujimu, ujimu. Jimmy. La phezulu, boza Jimmy. Jimmy, 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 silinde wena. Jimmy, Jimmy. Akanyuke ze la stage. Amandla. Amandla. SG usezokhuluma, Jimmy, how far? Jimmy, Jimmy. Stella Sonden. Amanda. 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 How are you? How are mama? 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 How are mama? 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 Let the mama go long akali. Hey, hey, hey. Mama, 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 the Secretary General of the Economic Freedom Fighters, also known as Shisambama. He is here to address us and akhulume nalamasela, akhulume nalama racist. Ngicela before USGS lama fighter ngala onke lama fighter la, all of you here stella nizela ngaphambili onke lama fighters ethunzini fighters for a few minutes, high morale, high discipline. Let's move here. Ngenkathi ngibiza lengoma uyamuva uyasuka ethunzini wa in a revolution. I leadership is here ishiswa ilanga. Let's move. Since the long affront, USG is about to address. And I'm not going to allow SG to come here and address Sanike Ngeyintonga. We are in a revolution. We must come and stand here. USG akhulume nathi. Asondeleni, asondeleni, asondeleni fighters. Let's move, let's move, let's move. Asondeleni, let's take the center stage. Sibe la front. Come, come, comrades, behind the truck. Let's move, fighters. Lapho otongeni. If you are a member of the EFF and you are disciplined, and then we tell you to move from the wall, you move from the wall. And we're not going to proceed until you do that. If you are a disciplined member, your EFF, Masiti Suga Otongeni, take the center stage. You are going to do exactly that because we are in a revolution. We are here to fight. We are not here to nurse anybody. We are fighting. And Lamasela Lawa, they must feel what you are not here to play. For too long, Lamasela Kongolos have been doing as they please. Bakhaphaza abasebenzi bengayilethi service delivery, and no one dared to challenge them. But today sikhona la sizodila nabo, and the secretary general is about to speak. Nobala umkhulu
Mandla Mandla
Mandla
Mandla I show me fighter, I show me. Don't leave the commander in chief lonely. Don't leave the commander in chief lonely. Don't leave the commander in chief lonely. Manda. Thank you very much, Stalo. Spigerele umholi. Obsuwe national, obulito ukomisa. Unonta norolchungu. Spigerele ukomisa oleita ileipates. Ukomisa ulengiwe. Spigerele umholi we province. Spigerele umholi mama region. Spigerele umholi mama branch. Ground forces, fighters. Ours, it's a land revolution. Ours, it's a land revolution. Everything else esiyenzayo kufanele sazi ukuthi the first mandate of the EFF is to make sure that the land that belongs to our people, it returns to our people. So every day when we're on the streets, that is why today we have to stop there, because we wanted to demonstrate to anyone here in Newcastle that things that we are visitors in Newcastle, that these are our streets, this is our land, because ours, it's about land. And until the land has gone back to the hands of the people, our revolution continues. So we must never make a mistake. There must never be anyone who comes and confuses us and think ours is about being councillors, and think ours is about taking the municipalities. That is a, by the way, ours is a land revolution. Every day we must know that until all our people are in charge of this land, in the entire province of KwaZulu-Natal, it's not yet Uhuru, and we're going to fight and we're going to defeat the enemy, because we know our enemies are those who refuse to hand over our land, and we must not play games with them. Our people here in Newcastle, here in Amachua, they are still being shot like pigs, like dogs, by racist farmers who continue to subject them into poverty, who continue to take their livestock, who continue to treat them like slaves. We must go and attend to those races, because ours is about land. You know, under this leadership of the cowards of the ANC, when there are land claims that are currently happening, they say to you, our black people, when they want to occupy land, when they want to go to the farms, they say, no, you must not go there. You must wait, because we are still processing paperwork. This is the direction. We must go and occupy these farms. If they are processing paperwork, white people, they must wait, and black people, they must wait. If white people are eating, black people, they must eat in those farms as well. We are charged of waiting in the sheds. We are charged of waiting in townships. And white people, they continue to exploit our farms. They continue to generate income when we are watching as visitors. We must go and stop them. If there is paperwork that's going to happen, all of us are going to wait for that paperwork. That time is over. We must stop talking. We must go and harass them. We must go and demand our land, and we must go and demand it now. We must do so, fighters, because
Our people are hungry now. Our people, they don't have jobs now. Our young people, they don't have houses as we speak now. Our parents, they don't have houses now. So there is no time for waiting. This is the time for action. That's why we're consolidating the ground. Let's make sure that each and every street in Newcastle belongs to the EFF. Let's make sure that each and every shipping belongs to the EFF. Each and every church must belong to the EFF. Each and every house must belong to the EFF, and we must go and take our land. You must not be fighters who talk too much and sing every day. It's time for action now. Because we continue to die. We continue to explain ourselves to visitors that have taken our land for the last 300 years. We've been begging these people. We've been negotiating with these people that we want land, we want peace, we want inclusion, we want equality. They have refused. We're no longer talking peace now. We're talking action. So the other race must be responsible for peace. Because black people in this country, they are the only one who are responsible for peace. Every time we want to negotiate with them to say, let us share in the land of this country, let us share in the minds of this country, let's share the economy of this country. The only thing this white race say too, they respond to us with violence, with exclusion and exploitation. As we speak today, our parents in these shops, they are still exploited. They work for 10 years, they call them ama casual. Every time when they want to fire them, they get rid of them like dogs. That must come to an end. We demand decent jobs. We demand equality. And fighters, no one is going to bring it to you except this revolutionary movement. But it's going to need hard workers. Because a revolution is a duty of hard workers. A revolution is a duty of the fearless. If you are weak, you are lazy, and you are a coward, you must know that you don't belong in the revolution. You must leave us alone because we're going to attend to them. The time of begging them, the time of negotiating peacefully, it has come to an end. You must know that you're oppressors by nature. When you know that they agree to your demands, they only agree to your demands because we have not touched their comfort zone. Uma abanizwa la eNewcastle kuthiwa, hayi kunomlungu weplazi, lo mlungu ufundisa izingane zabantu abamnyama. Ukuthiwa kunefemu la iyadonate yakhe iclinic. You must know ukuthi they are just trying to manage our revolution. They are trying to redirect our struggles so that our struggles, they are not dangerous for them. We must tell them that enough is enough. Our struggles are going to be dangerous for them. When we go for them and they approach us with violence, we're going to respond with violence. If they threaten our lives, we're going to take their lives because we're tired of joking. We must go and prepare the ground, fighters. We must go and prepare the ground. Let's make sure that this municipality, this region, belongs to the EFF. Let's make sure that the land here belongs to black people. We must suffocate our oppressors. Now we have passed the stage of reconciliation. It was the ANC that was talking reconciliation, a useless reconciliation, that we must exchange fake smiles with white people in the restaurants. We must exchange fake smiles with white people in the corridors. We don't want reconciliation. We want justice. And justice is the return of our land. You know, when they say there is a rapist and justice is served, it means when there's evidence, they must arrest that racist. They must sentence him to life. They must put him in a dark cell and they must suffocate him there. Even if he dies there, that is fine. So the justice that we're seeking for is that they must get our land back. These races who continue to own thousands of hectares, we must suffocate them. Let them go in and stay in matchbox houses. Let's go and suffocate them because we are need enough our land and we need our land today. Fighters, there is a story that is moving around here, including this useless clown here who calls himself a mayor. Our people have been asking for land. 26 years later, our people have not received land. So when our people, they go and occupy land, they build houses. These mayors, they go and send the security police, they go and demolish the houses of our people. So this should be the direction everywhere in KZN, starting with this mayor of this municipality. Because I'm told that he wants to demolish some house, some low-cost housing, where our people, they went to build in some space where they build their own houses without any assistance from the municipality. He has issued an instruction that those houses, they must be demolished. So what needs to happen, fighters? We must know the address of the home of this mayor. The day he demolishes our houses, we going to demolish his house as well. So that we must not tolerate nonsense. If they treat us with fire, we must be stoned with fire as well. When our people are going to be fire with fire. There's no time for talking. Because if we continue to accept this ill treatment from these people, we're not going to go anywhere. But fighters, especially young fighters, you must stop being cowards. A revolution is not a game of cowards. Every time our parents, they come back from these Chinese shops, they are saying they are treated like slaves. They are made to sleep in shacks. They even close them. They don't allow them to take lunch, and they pay them with peanuts. You young fighters, you don't rise. You don't protect the dignity of our parents. It must come to an end. Once we hear that there is a factory of the Chinese that is ill-treating our parents, we must go and close that factory until they can respect our parents. You must stop negotiating. Because you are behaving like cowards. You think someone else is going to come and fight your battles. You want to accept defeat from our enemies. If you are a fighter, you don't accept defeat. You fight for victory and you achieve victory with any means necessary. We must defeat our enemies. You young people, young fighters, you complain. Some of you are educated, you are graduates, but you go even on the robots to humiliate and embarrass all of us. You wear your gowns, nipatama pepa no me rema robotin. I'm a graduate, a civil engineer. I'm looking for a job. You know that these traitors of the ANC, they will not create jobs. So you are trying to appeal to the hearts of the racists. You are trying to appeal to the hearts of the oppressors. You think by standing in robots and humiliating yourself, they take your pictures like you're an animal in the zoo. You think they're going to feel sorry for you. You think what you are doing, Bambatakaman means that you don't try to negotiate with these racists. You think Sabuka did not try to negotiate with these racists. You think Sikukune did not try to negotiate with racists. You think Bigo did not try to speak to them. Don't embarrass yourselves. If you are a young fighter, that you are told, because your kids, they will ask, what happened to my grandfather? What happened to my mother? And we're going to be told that he died from poverty-related diseases. When we are told that this country is rich on land, this country is rich on minerals, there are opportunities here, but we are scared of white people, we are scared of our enemies. We sit in the shacks, we sit in the bedrooms of our parents because we want someone to feel sorry for us. You must know that you did not die of poverty, you died of cowardness. Because you were a coward, you couldn't confront the enemy. You must stop feeling sorry for yourself. If you are a young fighter who still stays in the backroom of your parents, you must know that you are betraying the work that your parents have done when they confronted the enemy, when they confronted the races. They said, we are doing it so that our kids, they can have freedom. Our parents, they achieved political freedom. Now it's a time for economic freedom, and we can't ask our cocos, we can't ask our mom Kulume to go and fight for us when we are being lazy and we are being cowards. If you are still staying in the back room, you must rise, you must mobilize, you must go to these shopping centers in the township and ask them that how many shops that are here and how many shops that are owned by black people. If there are no shops that are owned by black people, close the shopping mall. We must demand to eat in the table. There's no time of begging. Asike skatho ukusicela ukuthi nathi silambile icela nisiphakele. Siyajova manje siyetafule. Oba yakho umuntu ozalela edlile la emajuni. Siyajova manje siyetafule. Ngomanzi oqhubekana amagwala kusho ukuthi nizobulawa indlala. Kodwa ukudla kukhona la emajuni. Umhlaba ukhona la emajuni. We must go and consolidate the ground. We must go and work hard and make sure that these betrayers, these liars that were given power in 1994, they are removed from every space in government. We take over government not because we want to be councillors. We take over government so that we go and make laws, we go and take our land, we go and take our economy, and we give it back to our people. Because if you think you're going to take this municipality, go and fruit by my council, that means you're going to kill each other. That means we are clueless. You don't understand this revolution. You must go and read the founding manifesto of the EFF. It doesn't talk about councillors. It talks about the return of land. It talks about nationalization of our minds. It talks about the return of the economy. It talks about free education. Until free education has been achieved, and we must no longer talk peace, we must demand free education. Whoever is on our way, we must attend to him with fire. Fighters, we must go and work the ground. If you are a fighter and in your street you still see a yellow t-shirt walking like a mayor of the ANC as if it's got land, you must know that you are not a fighter, you are a coward. Because when you're a fighter, from today you go and take over your street and you say to all the traitors wearing yellow t-shirt, this is the street of the revolution. You got no place to walk in here. Go and try some other streets. These streets belong to the EFF. We don't want any nonsense in this street. Let's make sure that this revolution is fought at the street level. You must go home. You must go and occupy each and every street. From the right to the left, make sure that is the street of the EFF. So if you're a fighter, every day you wake up, you see a yellow t-shirt or a blue t-shirt, you must know which you have not done your way. You must know which umsebenza ngakawuqala, because you must make sure that there is no street for our enemies. You must make sure that there is no street for these traitors. Make sure that the ground has been consolidated. We are moving forward now. 7 years later, people of Newcastle, they are waiting for victory. 7 years later, these communities that open their houses for you to go and speak to them, they are waiting for you to lead them into action. There must be action here. We can't be told stories that there is a white farmer who has shot black people in a farm, but it stays the wife and the husband, and there's thousands of us on the side of the road. We are too many, man. The numbers are making sense. Let's go and take over our farm. If he wants to fight, we'll beat him there.
Yeah, bro.
Let's go and take over. Since I knew Castle or Coco, Master Uchi, Lomlu, Tate, Komo's army, Watata Lembus's army, Kitel Marketing Yashis Alapa, Watati Komo's Amos, Fabu Poison, Uzbuleni Komo's Amebegina, Seven Pilagazo, but the fighters are not rising. If Bafari Komo's Abo Mama Betu, Abo Coco Betu, Upoisi, Tatu Poison, you'll find Komo's Abedu, fire with fire. We must stop talking. Because we must treat them the way they want to treat us. But fighters, when we do that here in Newcastle, here in Amaju, we are told that even the police, when our people, they go and report the matter to the police, they take the side of the racists, they take the side of the farmers. We are saying to you, fighters, if the police here in Newcastle, in Amaju, they continue to take the side of the farmers, they take the side of the racist. When we are confronting racists, you must tell them that you are no longer police, you are security guard of the farmers, you are security guard of the racists, and you must attend to them as well. Because I'm a police officer, I'm missing on the man Djibouti. Gaba ma police are government, gaba ma police are Belu. They must take a decision. But we have a communicator now. Because we cannot continue to have a situation where the South African police, their duty is to protect a white man. When black people are meeting, they are here today. But we are told here in Newcastle, there's gangsterism, young people are dying every day, the police are not arresting anyone. We are told here in Newcastle that our mothers, they can't sleep off home because there are a lot of drugs here, but the police are here with us. because they were preparing to shoot at innocent and peaceful black people. We don't have other chicks to give. If they want to have a problem with us, they must continue to treat us the way they treat us. Because they go and defend farmers. These farmers are ill-treating our people. They kill our people. And nothing happens. Not even one farmer has been arrested in the entire Majuba. But black people are being killed and exploited in these farms, and police are defending them. Even when they report, they say to our people, you know, we can't arrest Abelungu. If they are scared of arresting Abelungu, we'll go and arrest Abelungu ourselves. Because we're not scared of Abelungu. We must go and prepare the ground fighters. Let's make sure that each and every street, if you're a fighter every day, make sure that there is no one that passes in your house, there's no one that passes out of your rank without you speaking to that person and conscientizing them and telling them that this is a revolution that is going to bring economic freedom. So fighters, we're not going to waste time. We came to tell this mayor here, that is a young boy, there is nothing he can do. He won't do anything during the day, he won't do anything at night, he won't do anything even on Sunday. We will defeat him every day with all the power from the ANC. We are not scared of them, and there is nothing they can do. He must comply to this memorandum. Because this is the last memorandum we are bringing. This is the last paperwork we are bringing. If they don't comply to this memorandum, these are our offices. If they don't comply in this memorandum, fighters, these are your offices. You must find out to pass all the floods in this municipality, because this is our municipality. We're tired of talking. We try to negotiate with them. We try to be peaceful with them, to say our people are suffering. We need services. They take this money of services, they go and give it to their girlfriends. When our young fighters, when our young children, they're looking for jobs qualified, they don't employ them. They go and employ their girlfriends. When you are looking for jobs, they want to sleep with you. We are tired of accepting that nonsense. We're no longer going to accept that nonsense from the ANC people. They must know that they've tested our patience long enough now. So there is no time for any memorandum that's going to come in this municipality. If they don't respond within the days that we've given them, we're occupying here. When the president says to you fighters, when you see a beautiful piece of land and you like it, you must occupy it, look like this building is very beautiful. Maybe we must start occupying here. Because they don't know what is the use of this building. They are not providing services in this area. So look like we must occupy here. So as you live here, fighters, you must decide which floor you're going to live in. Because look like we must occupy here. If they don't know what are these municipal offices, what is the purpose of municipal offices? We must go and occupy them. So you must start looking which floor you are occupying. So that on the day when you are saying you have failed, for 25 years you've been sitting here, snoring and not doing anything, it's time to go. We must go and occupy, and we give leadership to this municipality. So let's go and consolidate the ground fighters. Let's go and make sure that every day as fighters, we speak to the people of Amachu. We speak to the people of Tanhouse, people of Amadangeni. They must know that EFF is their last hope. EFF is their only party that is not scared of our enemies. And we know who are our enemies. It's those that took our land. We know our enemies. It's these that are stealing our resources. It's the one that are refusing to deliver services. It's the one that are abusing our mothers and workplaces. It's the one that are exploiting our brothers and factories. All of them, they are our enemies. And we must go and confront them. Fighters, it's time to attend to these people. So let's just go and prepare the machinery. Because now we are preparing this machinery. Next year, 2021, we are going to elections. Let's go and prepare the ground. Let's go and chase our enemies. Let's go and find our enemies. Let's go and defeat our enemies. So that come 2021, there is victory for EFF. This is the municipality of the EFF. This is the region of the EFF. Let's go forward to victory. Forward to victory, forward. Forward to victory, forward. Forward to victory, forward. Say Tati Nukasala municipality. Say Tata. Say Tati Machuba region. Say Tata. Amanda. Amanda. Thank you very much.
Wanga lenja siyenza yo azwe
Amuvalo, ongalenda siye, ongalenda siye nzayo, ongalenda siye nzayo, ongalenda siye nzayo. Amuvalo, ongalenda siye, amancha. Ukulume ilu SG, akekho ozokhuluma sikhuluma uSG. Ngizobiza u-deputy chairperson we-province azokwenza i-vote of thanks. Woza sekela sihlalo. Amandla
wethu.
Mandla
wethu.
Amandla phambili with the ground forces of amajuba phambili. Phambili with the ground forces of amajuba phambili. Mandla thank you very much chairperson. Siyabonga kakhulu secretary general. PCT members who are present here, and also other fellow ex-officials, RCT of Amajuba, ekhona la namhlanje, ground forces, branches, party agents. Siyabonga kakhulu baholi. But also want to send a clear message today. We've been fighting in this municipality from 2016. Sekwanele, comrades. Enough is enough. We've been fighting here and were met with arrogance. They're using the arrogance of numbers. They don't apply any superior logic on taking our council resolutions here. So we must go on the ground as the leadership has mandated us and given us a directive. We must go street to street, corner to corner, VD to VD. We must go and make sure Uti, we turn those people to be EFF supporters and EFF members. Siyabonga kakhulu, comrades, ngokuyinikela kwenu, ground forces, the battalion of the leftist movement. You've been with us since day one, since mobilization. Even some populist demagogues try to deviate you from the Clarion mission, yokwenza umsebenzi organization, but you stood firm. Nayisebenzele organization ngokukhulu kuyikhandla. Also, we are saying SG, there are 223 employees abaqoshwa la. 223 employees abaqoshwa be demanda of what they deserve. Ama overtime ababoyikoleda yilo masipala. Baqoshwa without any hearing. We are saying to you, comrades, go and look for those people. As from Monday, mangabe kade ku truck driver, we as the EFF sibanikeza ikhiye babuyele emsebenzini. Mangabe kade eyiklina, we as the EFF siyamnikeza sithi na umshanyelo, qhubeka ubuye street cleaner la. Qhubeka nomsebenzi okade wenza. Mangabe kade kuyiclerk, qhubeka nomsebenzi okade wenza because baqhasha obhululu babo la. The branch chairs and secretaries of the ANC are occupying these offices. So, what here, comrades, the mission, Pumile in line of march, let's go and consolidate the ground. Now, moving forward, comrades, let's not be all over like developing. We know good business is in Nila. So everyone must go back home as safe. We must love and protect each other, comrades. Look after each other. So ukubonga kakhulu i-leadership ye-national, ukubonga u-secretary general, the chairperson of the province and other fellow PCT members who've joined us. Amandla!
Awethu!
Awethu!